currency. I need some heat, and I need it right now, please. Let's get it. Back again. I finally got my PS5. Ghost of Tsushima in 60 frames per second. Looks amazing. Straight beautiful. But I'm off that. We back. We back, bro. Yes. Yo, what's good? This is Chill. Back with another first listen. This time, it's the homie Currency with Collection Agency. This project came out late February. Haven't heard anything about it. Haven't heard any tracks off the project. I'm super geeked to hear it. I've covered a couple Currency projects so far on the channel. Honestly, I started listening to Currency about the same time I started listening to Wiz. Main reasons why I go to Currency is because of a vibe. That man, he drops consistent projects. They're usually pretty short and straight to the point. I fuck with him heavy out of Louisiana, man. This dude got ties to Cash Money, No Limit, Wiz Khalifa, and it keeps going, man. But you know how we do over here, and I don't even really want to waste any more time. Once again, this is Currency with Collection Agency. Let's get it. All right, let's go ahead and get this project started. Coming in at track number one, we got Kush Through the Sunroof.
Step out your after me and bring my bong with you. I'm that nigga, that mother fool's just pretending they jury costume, variety, and all they cars rented. The way I look at it, they all enemies.
Let's go.
I took it back to my old energy. That's it, let's double. And she telling me she feel the chemistry. That's bullshit. She just know I'm rich. But keep going, sweetie. They calling for peace treaties. Even Kush through the sunroof.
Okay, let's see what you're doing, Currency. All right, so that was track number one, Kush Through the Sunroof. Dope track, man. Like a lot of these artists that I love, man, just pretty much setting the vibe for the project. Man, like, I like what he's doing. Currency, Wiz Khalifa, Larry June, Devin the Dude. Even though Devin the Dude is a little bit different, they all kind of set a vibe for me. They consistently give you what you came for, and I greatly appreciate that. It's just cool riding music. Not much else to say. Let's go ahead and get to the next track. All right, coming in at track number two, we got Smile on Me.
Yeah, she made crepes, she watching her weight.
Okay.
She wearing my robe, she made me a plate. Not my preferred taste, but I still ate. What more can I say? I don't want to talk too much. I'm high from the sky. Come the lines, then I pin them into rhymes. There's a paper thin line between surviving and dying. Keep changing clothes, alibis. Never trust the phone lines. Chrome on the old school rise. The newest spaceships get the three pieces. All the ancestors smiled on me. I got diamonds on my dial, homie.
All right, so that was track number two, Smile on Me. Dope track, man. Love the instrumental, like the rapping. Saw where he was coming from, talking about my ancestors, smile on me. Basically, what he's talking about is due to what his people came from, it allowed him to get what he attained today. Not discounting his own hard work, but like I said, the experiences and the upbringing, it all came together in what he became today. So, dope track, man. It was pretty short, not much else to say. Let's go ahead and get to the next track. All right, coming in at track number three, we got Arrival.
I used to ask my mom if I could hook my Nintendo up to her TV. Now I swap her Mercedes out like every Christmas Eve. I arrive stoned, thuggish, ruggish bone. For the love of money, loved ones do you wrong. When they see you shining, angel on the hood of the color, and doing 100 in a thunderstorm. Flying the plane myself, I told the chauffeur to stay home. I arrived stoned, I arrived alone. Put that shit on before I left my home. Success is my cologne. Thuggish, ruggish phone.
All right, so that was track number three, Arrival. Man, to be honest, I didn't really get much from that track, though the instrumental was super dope, provided by Harry Fraud. Currency, man, like, he did his thing. I believe I've had this critique before from Harry Fraud's production. My man is super laid back, and when you couple him with somebody else who's super laid back and not gonna give you any type of variance or nothing super interesting, I won't say boring, it just gets a bit samey. Like, it never went anywhere. I didn't hate the track, I just wish I got a little bit more of it. I do appreciate receiving a vibe, but sometimes I need a little bit more than that. But hey, man, we three tracks in, that was only 2 minutes, so hey, what more can you say? Let's go ahead and get to the next one. All right, coming in at track number four, we got I Don't Call.
I got a caddy, I don't drive, bitches, I don't call. I got a crib I never go to with money in the wall. Bitch, you gotta stay down, even though I'm a dog.
Got a retro feel to it.
Could be a story of glory or a horror thriller. Documentary about the life of a broke nigga won't sell me those tickets. I'm too busy. Don't bring attention to me. I make millions from being calm, making calculated decisions. That's the way I gotta work. Keep me out my position. We can't be involved. That shit never happens. Shit like I can't gone drive, bitches gone calm.
Okay. All right, so that was track number 4, I Don't Call. Pretty dope track. The instrumental was dope. I like that hi-hats on the track. The way he put his hook over those hi-hats, I appreciated that. He definitely knows how to match a hook. Again, I'm hoping for a little bit more. Like I said, I know what Currency's gonna come with. He sets that vibe, but it's like, something seems to be missing in this. I don't know. Let me know if I'm bugging. Let me know what you guys think so far. With all that being said, let's go ahead and get to the next one. All right, coming in at track number 5, we got Jermaine Dupri.
Rain on the fan, the windshield tears when the friends kill. How that shit feel? You not equipped for
give
the
me a
field.
Little bit of a drop, please.
Smell. Pulled up on factory wheels with the racing gear. I could make a million appear. No back and forth with a boss. They have for me in airports cause dogs smell me. Y'all sketchy. That's why y'all can't catch me. Try text me 5-7's front.
Bruh, I'm fucking with this track so far. I just wish they would have gave me that full bass knock when it dropped out, bro. It kind of muted it out or kind of made it so it doesn't hit as hard. They would have gave me that full knock, we probably could have went somewhere, man. Damn, that was just a little bit of a missed opportunity, but still dope so far. Harry Frog, he supplied it on this, man. It's up to Currency to finish it on out. My bad, let's get back to it.
MTV trip, Jermaine Dupri had the Continental T in the garage. Say you ain't a big dog unless you got one of these. Never missing my mark.
I need that full drop, bro. All right, so that was track number 5, Jermaine Dupri. Pretty dope track, man. I fuck with that instrumental. I just wished it would have had a little bit more of a drop so I can feel those full 808s. But even without that, it was still pretty fire, man. I appreciate it. That was fun. I kind of get why the title of the track was Jermaine Dupri. It was in reference, I believe, to his Cribs episode when he was talking about, you're not a big dog if you ain't got one of these. Outside of that, I didn't really catch it. Still dope, man. I fuck with that track. I just wish it would have took that next gear, but hey, man, you know, you can't always get what you want. Let's go ahead and get to the next one. All right, coming in at track number 6, we got Closing Date.
I just got the keys to a closed down grocery store. We parking cars in it. We stars really getting it. You fools, bars really. This shit hard lifestyle. Niggas kill for cameras in your yard. Niggas creeping through your doors. It appears that you have been sent for. Still getting better and better at how I do it. If you could imagine, D93 is on the E-Class wagon. My homie's active.
All right, so that was track number 6, Closing Date. It was an all right track, man. The hook wasn't standout enough. The verses didn't do enough. Although it was dope to me, that's my personal preference. I don't feel it did enough. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I just feel they should go another level. The beat was smooth. I mean, everything, he was in the pocket. He stayed in there. He wasn't doing anything cringy. It just didn't pop for me. I'm still having a good time. I enjoy Currency, you know. Let's go ahead and get to the next track. All right, coming in at track number 7, we got Shout Out featuring Larry June. Looking forward to this one.
Understand I got options and I place you on top of them. But it's your spot to lose. This life come with some rules. We laced in real jewels. My OG hit me to it. I know how y'all coming. You come run up on me. I swear you get laid out for nothing. My home is down the slide from me.
All right, man. So far, Currency, he did enough. It wasn't nothing crazy stellar. June, come on, bro. We gotta bring this home. Don't really like the hook. I wish you would have did it. Hopefully you do your own rendition of it. Let's get back to it.
Shout out my watch is real. Shout out my bitch, she real. Shout out my niggas, they real.
We turning heads when we walk, skin so soft. Leather so soft, adjustable exhaust. I'm catting off. I told you I can show you what we go do. I keep shit lit, that's it. Look at my wrist, that's him. Look at my bitch, goddamn. Bitch got ass like shit. I'm that nigga still. Shout out my bitch, she real.
All right, so that was track number 7, Shout Out featuring Larry June. Pretty fire track, man. Currency came on, set the alley-oop for June. It wasn't a perfect alley-oop, but he got that thing up there. June caught it, kind of was gonna cock it back to dunk it, and I won't say he missed it. It went through, but he didn't touch the rim, you know what I'm saying? He just kind of threw it through, if that makes any sense, because he started off his verse pretty dope. The harmonizing, fire. And then it got off. That's just me being honest. That's my opinion. Still like the track, though. It was enjoyable. I'm definitely going to come back to it. Let's go ahead and get to the next one. All right, coming in at track number 8, we got Ferrari Engine.
Ferrari.
Ferrari engine, leave the whole fucking block trembling. Screen dough off the hinges, pull the raw pictures. Okay. I keep it real with my real niggas, duck snitches. I came up nothing to something really. It's like watching Rocket jogging through the streets of New Orleans instead of Philly. Driving okay. Cars, the American dream, I'm in the city. Ferrari engines, leave the whole fucking block.
Damn, that's it. All right, so that was track number 8, Ferrari Engine. To be honest, it really wasn't much to say. The track was only a minute 25 seconds. Didn't really do nothing crazy. I mean, as soon as it started going, it went out. So it was like, I don't honestly know how to feel. It wasn't bad. Let's go ahead and keep this thing rolling. All right, coming in at track number 9, we got Above the Law.
Above the law, at a level that they never saw it. Worried at all, they don't want a war, they want to talk. The cause, Paul, ducked off, off the map, still making the charts. As a Porsche, poison dog, driven like a R. I'm on the road, slashing the canvas, scrambled to the pad. Like Randall Cunningham when he couldn't pass. Above the law, at a level that they never saw.
Alright, so that was track number 9, Above the Law. To be honest, I was kind of disappointed by that. The instrumental was slightly interesting. Felt like I got more hook than verse. That was only a minute and 52 seconds, so out of most of that, all I got was hook, or at least that's all I remember. The rest of it was, but hey. Let's go ahead and get to this last track. Alright, we finally made it to the last track on the project. This is track number 10, Misty.
Yeah,
come on.
Yeah, keep it in. Shepherds on switch, baby.
All right, Currency, we finally made it to track number 10. This is the longest track on the project. The first 11 seconds of this seem like you about to go somewhere. If you've seen my videos before or if you're new, just rock with me for a second. Currency, I need some heat and I need it right now, please. Let's get it.
Watching the waves crash.
Let's go.
Jamming to my partner OGs and he make them slaps. Over by my LA woman's gray sweats, white Air Max pennies, first edition, vintage magic satin starter jacket, go perfect with them.
Currency, thank you, bruh. I've been waiting on some shit like this. Everything came together. The beat, the way you doing the verse, bruh. I wish I would have had this for 10 straight and I'd have no complaints. Thank you for bringing it home strong. Let's go ahead and finish it out, bro.
Bring me by my LA woman, yes. She got the gas. Sliding with my H-Town partner, we in the slab. By my Miami bitch, she got the fake ass.
Alright, so that was the last track on the project. Track number 10, Misty. Fire, fire, fire. I wish I had my lighters because I'd be flicking them bitches. Damn, Currency, it took you 10 to get to this, man. I had some other standouts, but this one here, bruh, the beat knocked. I don't know if there was a hook in there. I believe there was a bridge. I loved everything about it. My man was exactly where he needed to be pattern-wise to match the beat. The vibe was right. That was fun, bro. That was fun. But as far as the project as a whole, to be quite honest, I was kind of disappointed. And I feel like I got a lot of throwaways or a lot of B-sides in that. The project was only 10 tracks, 23 minutes. So if you're gonna do something that short, I expect you to give me some fire real quick. In my opinion, I did not get that. So hey man, I only had about 4 standouts on the project. Track number 1, Kush Through the Sunroof, 5, Jermaine Dupri, 7, Shout Out featuring Larry June, and track number 10, Misty. But as far as if I would recommend this project, this wouldn't be one of them ones, man. This isn't Currency's best. You can check out Outrunners. You can check out a lot of his other things. If you are a fan of Currency, of course, I throw it to you because he does set the vibe. But if you're someone new and you've never even heard of Currency, I wouldn't even throw this up on the board. This honestly wouldn't be it. Not that I hated it. It just didn't give me exactly what I wanted from Currency on a consistent basis. But hey, man, like I say, you can't love all projects. But with all that being said, let me know what you guys thought about the project. Let me know if you guys got any other projects you want me to first listen to. Please like, subscribe, share. We greatly appreciate that. And like always, chill out. No script.